Welcome back. This week is National MS Awareness Week. Multiple sclerosis is a chronic and unpredictable disease of the central nervous system, and more than 2.3 million people are affected worldwide. Many, of course, here in the United States and in Texas. Joining us now is Dr. Nancy Munson from UT Southwestern Medical Center and Leah Wetherill from the National Multiple Sclerosis Society. So, ladies, thanks for coming in tonight.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, we're glad to have you here.
Thank you.
So, first things first, a definition. For those who may not be that familiar with this disease, Leah, let me ask you to give us a brief definition.
Well, basically, Jeff, it's the interruption of information between the brain and the body.
Okay.
So when your brain sends a signal for your arm to move or to mm-hmm. recall a memory or to move your leg, it's interrupted and that message isn't delivered. Mm-hmm. So you see, with nerves running throughout your body, you can see a lot of different symptoms mm-hmm. and it presents very differently in person to person living with MS.
And it can affect anyone, any age, any ethnicity, sex, or is one group more than likely?
Yeah, well, women more than men, we know mm-hmm. that for sure. So 2 to 3 times as many women as men. Mm-hmm. Really in the age group between 20 to 50, but we're seeing kids as young as 6 months now becoming diagnosed with MS.
Is there a genetic connection? Are you more likely to have it if people in your family have MS?
Not necessarily. We do think that that's one of the factors, mm-hmm. but that's not necessarily indicative of an MS diagnosis.
Okay. And we're talking about this because this is National MS Awareness Week, so I know orange is your color.
Orange is our color.
And there's been a lot of efforts both locally and nationwide to raise awareness.
Yes, sir, there has been. We've really been trying to paint the town orange and really find fun ways to connect people with the work that we're doing and mm-hmm. give them the opportunity to support research like Nancy's. Mm-hmm. And also just the programs and services that we have, everything mm-hmm. from shopping parties to movie parties to dinners and, of course, sharing the work that we do.
Getting the word out. Yeah.
And
before we get too much further on that, I want to ask you about what people can do, but also there is a lot of research underway nationwide and also right here in North Texas, right, Doctor? So tell us what's underway at UT Southwestern and what some of the big breakthroughs have been.
So we probably know the most about the interaction of the brain and the immune system in the disease called multiple sclerosis. Mm-hmm. And usually when you get an infection in your body, your B cells, which are a cell type of your immune system, will make antibodies to find that infection
sure.
and get rid of it.
Mm-hmm.
What we think is happening in multiple sclerosis is that the B cells are making antibodies against the brain, and that is what causes the damage in the brain that stops the brain from talking to your body correctly. And what we did 3 years ago is we actually looked at the antibodies that are made by MS patients, and we found that the antibodies in MS patients are different from what you find in healthy people and people with other neurological diseases. And in fact, we can track that in a genetic fashion, looking at the DNA code of these antibodies, and we can tell with about 90 to 94% accuracy who will get that disease in the future, mm-hmm. just based on this test, and it's called MS Precise.
So there have been so many breakthroughs in the human genome and mm-hmm. researching our own particular DNA.
Right.
Is that related to some of the research you're doing?
So antibody genes, you're born with those, mm-hmm. but they change over time depending on what kind of responses your immune system is trying, what kind of things your immune system is trying to fight. So the antibodies can be different over time. And so what has happened to the baseline genetics of or DNA code of antibodies in MS patients is they're different than what you find in healthy donors, and that's what we can track.
It's so important. To fund this kind of research.
Well, it is. And honestly, we wouldn't be able to do any of that work if it hadn't been for the National MS Society funding our work.
Right.
They have really been the foundation for making sure we can get that. And if you've ever known an MS patient, one of the issues with them is that they take so long to get them diagnosed with their disease because it's a very complicated, unpredictable thing. And you're looking usually at, you know, younger women in their early 30s that have this disease, and it's a very scary time. And we're just thankful that we were able to apply some of our knowledge of the immune system to hopefully being able to diagnose patients sooner.
Great. Fantastic. And that's a big part of what this week is all about, is raising money.
We do.
Awareness and money.
Yeah, this kicks off our 70 days and $3 million campaign between our Walk MS events in Dallas and Fort Worth. And
that's then locally.
That is locally,
yeah.
here
okay.
in North Texas. And then our Bike MS Sam's Club Roundup Ride that'll be taking place on May 3rd and 4th.
Okay.
So we joke, my job is to raise money to keep her in a job, but her job is to put me out of one.
So, right. I thought you were going to say her job is to spend it.
Well,
you raise money and she spends it in a good way.
Yes,
Dr. Munson, Leah, thank you so much
thank
for coming
you.
In tonight.
Thank
it's really
you so
important
much.
Work, and we
yes,
appreciate everything you're doing.
Thank you.
So coming up next on the Texas Daily, a local anchor and TV news pioneer saying goodbye tonight. Do you know who she is? Oh, we know her well. We're going to talk to our longtime friend and WFAA icon, Gloria Campos, what she plans to throw away and how she's going to let loose now that she doesn't have to appear on TV anymore. Coming up.